Today, let us have a quick review on the external features of the heart. Now, what we have here is a heart specimen, and this here is the apex of the heart formed by the left ventricle, and exactly opposite to that, this here is the base or the posterior surface formed predominantly by the left atrium and also by some part of the right atrium. We then go on to see the other borders. This here is the inferior border. This is the right border. Superior border and left border, also called by some as the left surface. This here is the sternocostal surface formed by the right atrium, right ventricle and some part by the left ventricle. We then go on to see the left surface, which is formed by the left ventricle and some part of the left atrium or the left auricle to be more specific. The inferior surface or the diaphragmatic surface formed by the two ventricles, the left ventricle and the right ventricle. Then we go on to see the grooves. This here is the right atrium and this is the right ventricle. So this is the right atrioventricular groove. Similarly here, this is right ventricle and this is the left ventricle. So this here is the anterior interventricular groove. On the diaphragmatic surface, this is left ventricle and right ventricle, and this here is the posterior interventricular groove. Finally, let us identify the great vessels. This here is the ascending aorta, arch of aorta with its three branches continuing as the descending aorta. This here is the pulmonary trunk, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava related to the right atrium, and related to the left atrium we see the four pulmonary veins. So these were the external features of the heart. And how do we hold it in normal anatomical position? You rest the diaphragmatic surface on the palm and the apex should lie between the index finger and the outstretched thumb, and this is how you hold it in normal anatomical position. Thank you.